On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Now Brady. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Good coverage on the outside, and I think that's where he wanted to check that down to. But once he saw the danger over there, he just threw that one over everyone's head. Smart play.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and six. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. And that is incomplete. He had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. This is taken at about the 14. A very good kick there, but 15 yards on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9. Well, this defense for the Buccaneers, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away four times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver? And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. They'll look to throw here. Flushed out, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly, and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Back to throw. Steps away to his left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away, and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
And the defense, they'll spread the field, a dime package here on third and 12. They'll drop the throw. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him, and what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long, got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation, and they took advantage of the young man right there.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back, and he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed, and on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Working from the gun, it's Brady. It's complete, it's Miller. A gain of six there on first. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook. Pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Now Leonard Fournette. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Brady's throw there complete. Call it a gain of a yard. And they're going to face a third down. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football as they've got it with a third down coming up. Play action, now it's Brady. One that's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Panthers will take over here just shy of the 30. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it was a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they come into this one off the loss over the weekend. But you say if you're going to play a Thursday night game, this is the week to do it.
It certainly is because you get right back out there. You don't have time to dwell on things. And look, your game plan is going to be a little more limited, but so is theirs. So that's when you just appeal to your top players. Guys, you make plays in this one, we out-execute them, we can walk away with a win.
Escaping the pressure right. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Now he's flushed out left to the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
Now that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on third down, how about him buying some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open, and when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a first down.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Eluding the pressure right. And that's
going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete.
That one brought back a few nightmares, because when a quarterback gets outside of the pocket, your job as a defensive back, make sure you stay as deep as the deepest receiver and not let anyone leak behind you for a big play. A nice job there having discipline and not letting them connect on that pass.
Flush to his, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett, his second sack of the night. Jack Fox out to punt here on fourth down. Special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2 yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2 yard line.
So, what's your definition of ideal?
The 1 yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So, yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Back near his goal line, here's Brady. Open man, Gronkowski complete. They find some open field here. And all the way to the 25 before he's hit and dropped.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Mike 43. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
First down, Brady. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
On second and 10, Brady over the middle to Evans. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Brady. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From midfield, here's Brady. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off. If you're a lover of offense, this has not been the half for you thus far.
Luckily for me, though, I'm sitting next to a lover of defense, and we have had plenty of that, including that interception.
Yeah, and I mean, that still makes it a great game, doesn't it? Everybody talks about if the ball's not in the end zone and points going up on the board, it's not as much fun. I love these defensive battles. Something's got to give with these turnovers. Who can convert them into points?
Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. They're going to look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. They'll look to throw here on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. He'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Carolina! A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season as his guys are on the board first here tonight. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. Brady's throw taken in by Evans here. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. The final shot before half for Brady. Throw right side, taken in by Godwin. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The Panthers out in front and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Give it up to McCaffrey. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
On play action, now Brady. This is caught by Evans. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Certainly worth noting, he's now one catch away from 600. He's at 599 in his career. Into the red zone, it's Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. Three plays, three pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal, expect them to attack right here on this play.
Again, it's Brady. Zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Fournette again, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Leonard Fournette, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point up and good by Succop, and that will tie our game here in the third. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he returns this to the 22. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Back to throw here. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting.
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Jamel Dean. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning through 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. On play action, it's Brady. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with 3rd down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on 1st and 10. Here's a give to Fournette. It inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 44 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. Fournette. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
And what we just saw there, partner, was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
Brady now to throw. And he finds Gronk. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
And partner, in a tie game in the 4th quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
Here's Brady. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, 1st down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball 1st down in this situation because 2nd down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Fournette. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette with his 2nd touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And that makes the score 14-7. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this 4th quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off near the 42. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. Extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now 21-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A 2-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the 1st down marker. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's 2nd down. Looking to throw.
He's going to look deep for more. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not.
And now here's another interception. Picked up by Jamel Dean. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
54 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game. Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Brady now on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
And he'll get this forward only for about a yard, as that's going to take us to the 2-minute warning.
So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Leonard Fournette,
a 3-yard touchdown run.
And the Bucs are closing in on a third straight victory to start the campaign.
Extra point put through by Succum, and a lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Now this is going to be returned from the back line of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception.
Mike Edwards picks it off.
Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Second and 11.
Going to throw here. Completion left side to Miller. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Now a play fake. Brady. He's able to find Miller. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages.
Hey,
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. This will be incomplete. Oh, a dream chance for a D lineman, but he couldn't pull that one in.
They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football.
So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay.
And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Buccaneers, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll get a few extra days to savor this one before they take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll fall to 1-2. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, my not, for flexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not, paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I didn't die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day, I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop at the neck of the serpent, determined the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances, I'm gonna stay in the land. Some also move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors I'm mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand. I drop my guts. The world is us. So what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well. Yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing? Who wanna pump me up? Fatality really is up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double.
Flow, but we started from the gutter.
Stunned like no one stunned. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You cannot mistake me for another. I had to wait my.